He probably did that. Oh, would you look at that? Oh, would you look? What an idiot.
All right, now that my son cleared the bench.
Yeah, it's looking good.
He's going to build himself a box.
Today, I'll start building a fourth order bandpass box for a pair of unreleased 10-inch Ecstasy subwoofers from the 90s. Amplifiers produced by Soundman Enterprises, Inc., Mobile Solutions, and CT Sounds.
Ooh. Ooh, I like the front of these. So we'll definitely show the front.
What? Shh. Myth, I'm writing that.
Quiet on the set!
I write that.
I'm doing math! I can't do math if you're talking to me, boy!
Is this what we need?
Oh, come on! He drew a wiener on the paper. Quit dicking around!
Did you measure it yet? What is all this?
We're going up to here, dude.
Oh.
This is gonna be your only trunk space.
It's gonna rattle.
Area.
It's gonna rattle.
It might.
Take that out.
You take it out.
Take it.
Okay, so what we're gonna do is we're gonna go underneath about, see now the trunk tapers in. So you're gonna measure from the outsides. Cause if you measure from the goddamn middle, your sides are gonna stick out!
Did you build it?
We're gonna go.
That can't be thick, too thick to not fit in there.
22.
Cause there's these little.
Write down 22.
22.
Do 16 and 22. We're gonna put a slight angle on it. On the front and the back. Because when they're straight up and down, it looks like they're slanted the other way.
Okay, I don't care about that.
It's an optical delusion.
So we're gonna counterbalance the optical delusion.
That's gonna take so long.
With a counter angle. All right, we need
What are you looking at it for?
We need a width.
We're gonna go 16 and a 22. We're gonna go 1 inch back.
How's it gonna fit?
Nice. Okay, now we have a trunk bar in the way, so we can go as high as the trunk bar, Michael.
What?
The trunk bar!
We're gonna keep it kind of low and go 16. Because we're putting 10s in here.
Can you cut it now? Yeah.
Looking at a 7-month box build.
If I did it, it would have been done.
You're gonna do it.
No.
I'm looking at 7 months for you to do it.
If I did it, it would have been done.
If you would do it, you'd cut your thumbs off.
These woofers were never released because of bad timing. There was an ecstasy drug epidemic in the 90s. Kids were getting pulled over with trunkfuls of ecstasy, so they had to discontinue the subwoofer line. And because it was a front for smuggling ecstasy into the States from Mexico. Each woofer had a bag of ecstasy under the dust cap. These woofers came to me for free from legendsofcaraudio.com. So technically speaking, you could say I will be freebasing ecstasy tonight when I rip the dust cap off, and in 6 months when the box is done.
You need to keep the piece of wood against the gate. And then you gotta push it across, but if it kicks back, it's gonna fling the wood at you. So you hold it. I'll do one. You do the first one. Just push it evenly across. Go. Cut how it like stopped moving and it went this way a little bit. Now what happens is if that happens, it'll go like this and then the blade is spinning towards you. So if it goes on over the blade, it's going to fling the wood back. See what I'm saying? Listen. If you push it over here, if it's uneven, you're going to cockeye it. So this will keep your hand safe if it goes... And your hand goes... But your fingers fly off like hot dogs.
I like to cut the sides first, then test fit them in the car. Then if it looks like the box will fit into the car, I'll cut the back and bottom, assemble them outside of the car, then I can start measuring airspace. Then I'm able to decide how big I want the ported chamber and the sealed chamber to be.
Okay, if this is a giant box, will it fit? Nope, it's not gonna fit. We're gonna have to. Ooh, yeah, baby. That'll work. I'll probably let this go all the way back and then start the box a little bit in so we have a little notch in for the amp. So we could do a sealed chamber in the back towards the back of the car, ported chamber towards the front of the car because the grills line up like in here. The speakers are right here, so we could have the ports kind of going in, facing towards the window. And then we could do an acrylic window on the front, or the back of the box. This is the back. This is the rear of the unit. This is angled to fit the seat. That should end us up perfect right here. Ooh, baby. Fourth order.
These woofers were never released, so there's no paperwork on them. I don't have any parameters to simulate the subwoofer box output in the computer. Without the proper parameters, I'm risking my entire reputation by guessing the airspace and port size. This is where Mark from the Fab Kitchen would be lost. But not me. I'm guessing I'll land a perfect 34 hertz tune with a 2-to-1 fourth order, with 2 4-inch diameter by 10-inch long ports. What if it sounds like shit?
Swell. Find legendary old school car audio gear at legendsofcaraudio.com.
Upgrade your vehicle's charging system with a high output alternator from US Alternators. Visit usalternators.com. Down for Sound is an authorized dealer and offers the best prices on the brands they carry with the fastest shipping in the industry. Go to downforsoundshop.com.
Oh, go figure. Look at that. Oh, look at.
I think that'll be good enough to get the woofers in and tune the port. If we don't have parameters, we could just guess on a port size and see what the box tune ends up as. I don't think it'd be very hard to land a somewhat decent tune on those 10-inch woofers. I'm gonna go 31 and see if it fits.
The sides fit. Next, I'll cut a back and a bottom. These next pieces will have angled cuts.
We'll angle this back angle first, like so. Then this one needs to be cut at exactly this point. We have
have our back angle. Does it fit? Oh, it's so precise, and I didn't even measure. Wow. Son of a large, fat, whore, bitch, ass, fucking hooker.
I tried to fight it.
Shit.
This one's gonna go yonder.
That side's a cunt hair off. Are these not exact? What in the... Oh my. They're slightly different. This is 16. We got 3/4 inch MDF. That's not 3/4 inch. Pretty close. 15 1/4.
I want this box to look like a 90s style bandpass box with a plexiglass front to make it bump harder and a speckled purple and white paint job on the inside. I want it to look like Ecstasy subwoofers did get released and they built a demo car for the artist formerly known as Prince in the year 1999. I'm going for a period correct stereo system build to get the views up. We really gotta...
What did you have to do up here?
It was a had a high spot because I put bondo to around the edge off and had a high spot, but now it's good.
That one's looking silky. This is the perfect one. That's for the new F-150s. What is this? This fits up to 18.
It went up to the 19.
Oh, okay. And it has the OEM screen cut out and iPad over the OEM screen. That's cool because you can just bolt it in.
Yeah.
You just bolt it into the car and go pair it to the Bluetooth.
Pair it. Probably want to pair it.
Ooh, that feels good now.
The back panel and the baffle board will be the same size, so I'll cut another one of those, then I'll cut the front panel. Then I can start measuring airspace.
I'm gonna give her a slap out there. I like to just put the pieces in and mark it, and then line the blade up to cut right on the line. That way everything's exact and you don't have to measure shit. This will be the ported chamber, that'll be the sealed side. We'll have to start calculating the airspace to figure out where this needs to go. This one's done, it's going out in primer, the customer's gonna have it painted. This one looks nice. It's nice and smooth.
I think I left my wallet in your truck.
Okay.
Put the divider 5.8 inches in, we can have a sealed chamber of 1.5 cubic feet and a ported chamber of 4.08.
If we're at 31 inches wide, the insertion will be similar to this type of insertion.
Examining insertion!
Next time I'll cut some woofer holes in the baffle board on the CNC router, then we can start assembling the box. At this time, I'd like to address Russell's stupid joke from last episode. It wasn't funny, Russell. Your walnut joke was stupid. Mine was actually funny. You're just mad because your ball sack looks like a walnut, because it's shriveled up, because you never got your pee-pee sucked. The only nut you've busted is that time you slammed your ball sack in the toilet lid when you were 3. We will be announcing the next build soon, so be sure you're subscribed. You can support the channel by buying shirts, hats, and stickers at soundman.co. The new 9.7 inch side slider kit is out and it's awesome. Go check it out. Thank you guys so much for watching today's video. We'll see you every Monday and Thursday at 7 a.m. Support Amplified by purchasing iPad dash kits and Soundman merch from soundmanca.com. Take your fabrication skills to the next level with the tools and trainings available from mobilesolutions-usa.com. Check upcoming training dates at mobilesolutions-usa.com/training. Go to ctsounds.com to get a discount on quality car stereo equipment with coupon code SOUNDMAN. See what kind of stereo system you can put together for your budget at ctsounds.com.